state, and I'm sure that will be contested too. That's why we need to talk. Her right hand covered her mouth as she moaned. Jake looked at the house, where the light from his windows cut through the darkness. A shadow moved beyond him, probably Simeon circling around. Jake had the sudden desire to hop in the old Saab and cut a trail quickly back to civilization. She asked, nodding,
"Should I tell him?"
"That's up to you. I would have included him, but I've heard stories about his drinking. Didn't know what shape he's in right now. But to be honest, Miss Lane, he's your husband, and he should come with you tomorrow. That is, if he's in good shape."
"He'll be in good shape, I promise."
Jake handed her a business card and said, "Anytime tomorrow afternoon, I'll be in my office waiting."
"We'll be there, Mr. Bodine. And thank you for coming here."
"It's very important, Miss Lane, and I felt like I needed to meet you. We could be in for a long, hard fight together."
"I'm not sure I understand."
"I know. I'll explain it to you."
"Thank you, Mr. Bodine.
Good night." Chapter 7. After a quick late supper of grilled cheese and tomato soup, Jake and Carla cleared the table and cleaned the dishes. There was no dishwasher. And eventually settled in the den, which began where the kitchen left off, some 6 feet away from the dining table. 3 years plus in tight living quarters required a constant reassessment of priorities and attitudes, along with a vigilance against edginess. Hannah helped tremendously. Small children care little for the material things that so impress adults, as long as both parents are voting, little else matters. Carla helped her with spelling, and Jake read her stories, and as they tag-teamed through the evening, they also caught up with the daily papers and the cable news. At 8 p.m. on the dot, Carla gave her a bath, and 30 minutes later, Hannah was tucked snugly into bed by both parents. Alone at last, and wrapped together under a quilt on the rickety sofa, Carla said,
"Okay, what's up?"
Jake, flipping through a sports magazine, replied,
"What do you mean, what's up?"
"Don't play dumb. Something's up. A new case, maybe? A new client who can pay a decent fee, or perhaps even a huge fee that might rescue us from poverty. Please."
Jake won the quilt. Sally brought the iced tea and poured more lemonade. When she was gone, Jake said,